Hello everyone and welcome to this lecture on monolithic and microservices. Now in order to understand the concept properly, think of a movie ticket booking application. Now whenever you try to book a ticket, you go to the UI, you sign up, you book a ticket, you do the payment checkout and you get a confirmation of the movie ticket. Now in monolithic architecture, all the components are tightly coupled and all the communications that happen are internal to the system. Whereas in a microservices architecture, all components are separate. So basically you will be having user sign up as a separate component, ticket booking as a separate component and so on. And the communication happens via external interfaces, or these are separate APIs that communicate over the network. So when talking about the latency, there is a minimal latency in a monolithic application. Even though for microservices architecture, you apply the best practices and the best parallelism, still there will be a minimal latency which will be greater than the monolithic application. Talking about the language flexibility, for a monolithic application, you have to write the code in a single programming language. So all of the coding pieces are written in a single programming language. Whereas in microservices, you get the flexibility to code each of the component in a different language. Coming to the scaling perspective, monolithic architecture are difficult to scale than the microservices. Not in terms of adding the number of instances, but in terms of the wastage of CPU resource utilization. Consider an example where you have reached the maximum limit of a monolithic application deployed on an instance. Now you create another instance, deploy the same full monolithic application and you are good to go. But here the resource utilization of the second instance becomes less because the only traffic that is coming is on a single component. Now in a microservices architecture, you can scale individual components. So if the ticket booking component is the one that is getting heavy load, so you can scale that to 2 to 3 folds so that your application is still intact, resources are utilized properly and the cost is also saved. Coming to the deployment piece, monolithic applications takes more time to deploy and it's not a fail fast model. Whereas in microservices, you can deploy individual component, you can deploy on daily basis, even on hourly basis when you have very small change, and you can deploy those changes on individual components on a live production environment. Yes, there are companies that are doing that, whether you have a simple application, a simple component change that you want to deploy on a live application, you can do that. Whereas in monolithic, a small change, you have to deploy the entire stack again. So that makes a deployment bit harder than in microservices architecture. So overall, there are benefits for monolithic where we have extreme low latencies, higher throughputs, and for microservices where you have full control over each of the components and that can be containerized as well, running on a powerful ecosystems like Kubernetes. So from there, you can choose which architecture you want to apply. For most of the organization and with the trend in cloud native, the microservices architecture is getting much more adoption. That's it for this lecture. Thank you.